Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going to take a look at some strange behavior I've noticed yet once again here on May 26th of 2021 up near the sun on the eastern limb of the sun. We're going to come back and take a closer look at that here in a moment. The CME that was traveling towards the Earth from the sun has arrived. You can see how the density increased very, very quickly, going up to 30. On an average day, it's around 6, just to give you an idea of what's typical. 30 is very dense. That was the density of the CME that did arrive on time, as predicted by the Space Weather Prediction Center, right there. And that color indicated density, and it definitely showed up on the instrumentation, created a G1 class geomagnetic storm. Hopping over to the GOES X-ray flux, we've seen some C-class solar flares from yet another very active region that right now is turning away from the Earth, but we're going to come back and take a look at that here in just a moment as well. I wanted to share with you guys something that my friend Craig from New Jersey has shared with me now twice this week regarding the temperature in New Jersey reaching 98 degrees two times this week. They're at the 40 degree north latitude. I'm out here in the desert southwest, and today our afternoon high was around 98, 99. Degrees. When I took this screen grab, it was 93, but it was as hot in New Jersey now for the second time in a week as it was out here in the desert southwest. And we're at the 33 degree north, which is typically cooler. The farther north you go, the cooler it gets, but that's not the case right now in May of 2021. Wanted to show you guys a little video I took this morning of the eclipse. I did step outside. I saw it at 3:30. It was actually 3:28. I just used my iPhone. This is as good as I could get, a little video clip I took of the eclipse in progress. By the time I got my other camera ready, I was waiting on totality. Clouds rolled in, and I did not see any more of the eclipse than what you see right here in this little video clip, so I was glad to get that. And I took that video clip at 3:28 this morning. Total eclipse was around 4:15 or 4:14. I did receive some photos from different people around the world. This first photo was sent in by James out of Girvan, New South Wales, Australia. Really good photo of the eclipse in progress. That was also a supermoon, blood moon. Evelyn out of the Philippines, excellent photo of the eclipse in progress. There's the entire photo from a distance. Great job. San Jose, California. D sent this photo in of the eclipse as it was in progress from California. Paul from Cape Woodruff, South Carolina, captured a little bit of the eclipse from the East Coast. Melbourne, Australia, Pornima sent this photo in of the eclipse. Photo here sent in by Rod out of Queensland, Australia. That's of the supermoon. That's not actually of the eclipse. That was before it got started. Here is the eclipse in progress. Photo sent in by Rod out of Queensland. These two are good photos, much better than I could get. Like I said, when I stepped outside, I could see it. It was in progress. It was 3:28 a.m. Next thing I know, clouds rolled in, and that was all the eclipse I could see. So great job, guys, and thanks again for sharing those photos. Hopping over here to the website, looking at the Schumann resonance, you can see there was a pretty strong spike about 4 hours ago. That is consistent with the arrival of that very thick CME. The density was up around 30, and typically on an average day, it's around 5 or 6. So it was a very thick CME. Hopping over to the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera, looking at seismographs that monitor the mighty supervolcano. Have an absence of data over here at Hebgen Lake. Everything else looks pretty much consistent with what we've been seeing now for the past several months, with the exception of this earthquake activity at Pitchstone Plateau and a little bit over here at Moose Creek. Other than that, pretty quiet at the supervolcano caldera. May 26th was the full moon, 100%. It was a blood moon, supermoon, and it was the second supermoon of 2021. I want to take you guys now up to the sun, and something I noticed now, this is the third time I've seen this now in 2 weeks. There's some sort of a strange sphere on the east side of the sun. This was noticed by Tony back on, or at least it was shared with me by Tony, back on May 11th of 2021. I look at this every day, and I would have seen it eventually, but he shared these photos with me from the SDO, the Solar Dynamics Observatory. It's a spacecraft that monitors the sun constantly around the clock. So here's one on May 11th, perfectly round sphere on the northeastern limb of the sun. Then on May the 21st, it shows up again, as you're going to see right here. So here we go on May 21st. I noticed it again up on the northeastern limb of the sun. This time we happen to catch it moving. See it right there? Jumping off of the sun, looked like a big bowling ball moving off of the northeastern limb of the sun. Totally obvious. Here it is again. I slowed it down and you can see it right there. Undeniable. And it looks like the same size of sphere that we saw back on the 11th, right? So that's now two times in 10 days. Pretty much the same exact location, except for today. It's right down here below the equator, still on the eastern side of the sun, May 26th of 2021. You're going to see it right over here now. It's almost as if there's a dark sphere orbiting the sun. Watch it over here, and it becomes visible at certain locations in the sun's corona. See it right there? That's the third time now in less than 2 weeks. So that's way more than a coincidence. Watch right there. See it? Looks like a large sphere, like a planetary body maybe, on the eastern side of the sun. That's visible every once in a while. This is the third time we've seen it. We've seen it on May 11th, May 21st, and now May 26th. There goes again. Clearly, something coming out of the sun's corona was very close to the sun and then moving away from the sun, just like it did on May 21st, and probably the same on May 11th as well. We just happened to catch a screen grab of May 11th, but on the 21st and the 26th, you can clearly see something moving away from the sun that looks like a round sphere. Now I want to show you guys this very active region that's kind of rare. We haven't seen anything like this in quite some time, many, many years. This is a highly unusual sunspot. It runs north and south, and typically they run equatorial east and west. And this thing has grown exponentially just in the past 24 hours. It is turning away from the Earth, but I would not be surprised if this thing didn't start producing X-class solar flares in the next couple of days. This thing is a high-octane overachiever. It's right here, and that's a brand new active region that has formed in just a matter of hours. And the sunspot associated with this active region is huge. This one says big as Jupiter and quite possibly could get even bigger. So look for big things coming from this new active region as it's rotating away from the Earth, but don't be surprised if we see a very significant uptick in solar activity in the next few days. We're already starting to see a trend upwards, steady flow of C flares. That's probably going to go up into the M-class range, and I would not be the least bit surprised if we didn't start seeing X flares soon. So just a big heads up, guys, that's all. That active region looks very, very intense. I want to thank you guys for sharing your eclipse photos. If you guys have any photos you'd like to share, you can send those to reports at MrMBB333.com. All of the photos end up here at the Sky Phenomena Photo Gallery at the website, and sometimes I'll use them in a video just like you saw right here. Thanks for watching. Have a super day, and be safe out there.